Hey guys, how's it going? It's Ellie, your nerd again today, and welcome to Ellen Friends Retro. I don't know what this would be, but what number this will be, but we're playing Dead Rising 2. And we're back, and we got all the bonus content and everything, so I don't know if it works like it used to, so I'm gonna try doing something cool here. So we'll go psycho outfit.
Smooth.
Ninja boots, headgear, and then
nice.
Wait, no, I'd want that for headgear, and then can I have this as a dirty face? Yeah, I can have a dirty face, and then we'll have the I think it would be ninja boots. Yeah, because we have the soldier, we have the got the psycho, we got this, and then it would be the ninja boots. This is what I used to run.
Sweet.
So there we go. I'm back to where I used to be on this. And the only reason why I'm not doing Dead Rising off the record right now is just because I feel like doing them in chronological order of when I played them, so this would be the one that I just recently played. So yeah, I just skipped the first part of the stuff, so all you really do is just play, like, a Terra's Reality game, where if you get gold, you win a bit of money. So honestly, wasn't anything, like, too crazy, like, you guys didn't miss that much. And yeah, also, I beat Dead Rising 1 already, and I'm debating on doing a Dead Rising series of just me playing through it and putting it on the channel.
Hey.
Oh yeah, I'm not gonna be able to create anything cool yet. There we go. The good old sledge. The good old sledge. I forget what the collectibles are for this game. Oh yeah, it was spraying over the whole Zombrex logo. That's what the things were. It was spraying over these logos. Yeah, I remember now. Health plus one. Snack. I forget what I honestly ran in this game. Most of the time I just picked up like weapons and I just ran through the game. Because after Dead Rising 1, things got super easy. Like, they got too easy. Right on my first shot. Lucky me. And you can keep doing that each time you come back, or like, so you like unload the game and then you can just keep doing that, so it's like 10,000 PP constantly. Oh yeah, and fuck, I forgot about this game. Like, the worst part about this was the whole poker game mode, because back then I didn't know how to play poker, but now I do. So I was like super shit at it. And it was just like a secondary thing, but that's how you can get the Proto Man armor.
Oh, great. Hey! I know you're holding out on us. Where's the money? Where's the safe? Come on! Don't lie to me!
We don't have a safe!
Don't lie!
Hey, dirtbag! Let the lady go.
Why don't you mind your own business, old man?
Exactly what I'm doing. I'm just here looking for some Zombrex.
Well, you're definitely gonna need some painkillers when I'm done with you.
Well, talking to you is giving me a headache.
Oh, yeah? What say you give me some money, and I'll go get some for you?
Yeah, give us some money, Grandpa. We'll help you out.
How about it, Grandpa? You got any money?
I liked beating these guys down because you get, like, one of the best weapons out of beating them down.
Hey, let's take him out!
Fuck off. That was easy. Just slammed on those guys with that hammer. But yeah, the best thing about those guys, or whatever, you can get the light from them, and then you can make your own custom lightsaber. That was always the good thing to do. I think I'm okay, thanks so much. Blah blah blah. I go got some Zombrex.
Cool.
And that was another thing that a lot of people fucking hated about this game, was the whole, oh, you need to give her Zombrex type thing. Okay, yeah, we get the whole leveling thing. Okay, there we go.
What's up?
Can I carry you? No, I can give you an item, though. Alright, I'll give you that. It's about to break, I don't need it.
Thank you so, so much.
Come on! Still there?
I know a lot of reasons why people liked this guy, or like Chuck Green more than Frank, was because, like, he was just father figure. Dude just trying to help his kid. Alright, come on, let's go, lady.
Move it! Hurry up!
God, this game feels laggy.
Stick to me!
Wonder if that's just like the recording thing. But I forgot, this game was a bit laggy. You need to go, lady.
Don't fall behind. Keep moving. This way.
This game actually does feel a bit laggy.
Stick
I don't know,
me.
I might check and see what's wrong with it. Honestly, recording Dead Rising 1 wasn't that bad. Number 2 just feels a little laggy. Let's go.
Keep close! Keep it moving! Keep going! Come on! Stick close! Let's go!
Yeah, she's coming. Alright, alright, alright. Yeah, I don't know what that was. God, that was really bad. Like, that lag actually was, like, super, super bad. I didn't even get that while playing the first one. That's just kind of disappointing about that. But, yeah, no, like, I've always liked to talk about something different than, like, the fault of that. I always loved the Dead Rising series because it was something to look forward to, because like I loved all the games and how they were.
That's a real good way to get yourself killed, son.
Don't worry about me. I know my way around a zombie or two.
Oh, did she not get there with me? Oh, she didn't. I'm gonna have to go back and get her, because I forgot. His cutscene's actually supposed to be like, you know, hey, it's good that you went out and got somebody, but yeah, she wasn't here. God, you take forever. Fuck. Come on, lady, let's go.
Still there? Keep moving! Come on!
There we go. And also the other thing I actually liked way more about off the record, I miss taking pictures. That was, like, the best thing about it. Like, I love taking pictures. Taking pictures were awesome. There we go. Now I got an escort bonus. I didn't get the cutscene where he was like, hey man, you know, yeah, helped him out. I'm totally glad that you do that. There we go. Check the watch. Can I just... Okay, not right now. So I can, like, go around and mess around a little bit. But at least... excuse me. At least this game, something that I can say that I do like more than the other one, like, it got a little easier to play. Because, like, I'm not gonna lie, with Dead Rising 1, like, it's super, super hard. Like, a lot of the things. Also, too, I liked that they added where you can actually move and shoot. I'm just kind of coming around just to collect shit. Yeah, here we go. I forgot that it gives you like 60 rounds in the clip for this when you have the soldier outfit on. I think you only get like 20. That's what I always thought was cool about this. You get more ammo in the clip for wearing the soldier outfit in each other outfit. So like the other outfit I'm wearing technically right now, like I get a cool like special like kill animation. I think I take little to no fall damage. And then the beer drinker like helmet that I have on means that I can't get like food poisoning, so I can just stuff my face to my heart's content and I can just run through this game super easy. I remember on last gen they fixed that where you couldn't do it, then they changed it and they were probably just like, don't matter, like there's nothing competitive about this game is hard, you know, it's just to have fun. And this is also the era when actually wearing outfit, like, different outfits did something. Like, for Dead Rising, off the record, when you have... Oh, wait. Oh, shit. Oh. Let me get inspiration. Can I not get inspiration yet? No, I cannot get inspiration yet. Okay, let's see. So, it's... I still have, like, an hour or two to fuck around, so... But yes, this is the era of Dead Rising where wearing something actually mattered. Because, with this game, they decided to be like, alright, here, so if you're gonna wear this hat, it's going to, like, do something for you. Other than, like, nothing. Oh yeah, I forgot, also sports equipment. Sports equipment also lasts longer, I think, with this outfit. I think. Shit. Nope, stop it. Oh yeah, I forgot. Since there's a dude there, I'm just gonna have to knock him down. But yeah, just having all these outfits on at once just makes it so much easier just to run through and do it. Boom, there we go. Test of strength. Oh yeah.
Nice.
And then just break these to get some experience. But I need my fist. I forgot. Sorry. God damn it. Can I just hit you guys and just break it? No, I actually need my fist. There we go, perfect. Can I, like, hit it from over here? There we go, perfect. Broke all the dummies. Attack damage increased. Nice, so my attack damage is a bit more. And I'm still needing to wait till 8. To 7 to 8. So yeah, just run around and fuck around a bit. I always love this game. Like, it's just, it's such a fun and good game. And I love that they brought back the whole, like, all you need to do is just wear one part. Oh my god, I got him right there. Oh baby, look at that. Pretty much all you gotta do is just, like, there's nothing too hard about this game compared to, like, Dead Rising 1. And then even 3, like, 3 wasn't even that hard to begin with, but they didn't have, like, oh, if you wear this outfit, things will make it way easier for you. 6. Okay. I guess I can go back now. Also, too, if you guys want to see me play through these games, like, fucking comment down below and be like, yo, man, want to see you play it. Because, I'm totally down to do it. You know, I just like hearing, you know, what you guys would like to see me play. Yeah, I don't need that thing anymore. It's 6. Like, maybe I can go back a little early and do it. Between 7 and whatever. Yeah, because, like, it's at the red now. Also, I know that was another reason why people didn't like this game, too, was just like, you need to go back and give your daughter Zombrex, so you're not gonna get the best ending. But honestly, she is kind of a crucial part to the next game. To number 3. Because she's Nick's love interest on the third one. And gives kind of a reason for Chuck Green to come back. Can I give it to you now? Like at 6? Can I do that? No. Okay, I'm glad you found some. Yeah. Yeah, I know you're okay. But yeah, I think I can just drink as much vodka as I want. And, like, alcohol in general, and I can't get sick because I'm wearing the beer hat. Not the beer hat, the Vikings hat. Yeah, you know what, I'll just stay here and just mess around. So yeah, they start you off with predetermined people that are saved, and then later in the game, pretty much what happens is that this place will get overrun, and you can lose these people that have been saved. So it's something that you want to watch out for. Down here is just some extra things, like there's, yeah, so there's these things over here where you can try your luck at the lotto.
Ooh. You're my favorite.
And then get some more cashola. Forget what's over here. It's actually just been a while since I've been through these areas. Nothing. And then the room up here, this is where you play strip poker. Yeah, right up here. They'll invite you in to play strip poker. And that's when you get more people that you saved. And when you save the one old man with his son that's wearing the head for, what do you call it, for, not Power Man, shit, I forget what his name is, for Proto Man, there you go. Yeah, for Proto Man, you can get his thing. And that's what I thought was really cool about it, that you can get his Proto Man suit. I know you can, like, actually get, like, the Proto Man gun and everything else. But for me, more or less, this video was just me. For me, just starting back on here and then just playing through it. Just because.
Nothing's happened for a while.
And also, if you haven't seen or played the other games, I would suggest going and doing that, because these games are really good. Like, they're really, really good. Like, I love these games. Like, I love Dead Rising. It's a great series. The triple pack's really worth playing. So, I definitely suggest you guys to try it. But yeah, so, I guess I just keep waiting. Yeah, no, I don't think I really need any, but yeah, here we go. I'll just take that. Why not? Oh yeah, I forgot when I wear this hat, my hair's green. I forgot. Forgot about that. Yeah, a lot of these games have, like, really good stories, and they're just fun to play. Like, I'd love to do an episode of this with my buddy Todd, or someone, because, like, he has this game, too. Like, thanks to him, I wouldn't be playing, like, honestly, I wouldn't be playing those games right now. Like, I probably would have had to wait for a while, so. Yeah. But yeah, I love these games. Like, I've had so many good times playing Dead Rising with friends of mine. Okay, we're still waiting. Okay, we have like a minute. There you go. Give Katie Zombrex. There you go. I still find that such a dumb name for it.
Hey, honey. I told you I'd get some Zombrex.
Yeah, I just had to, like, murder a couple people.
Look, Dad, I got a new power in Mega Man.
Yeah, it's like, hey, man. Like, I murdered the shit out of some people. But that's cool. You got a thing for Mega Man. But yeah, I always thought that was cool. Like, I loved with Capcom and everything, how they always had their Mega Man nods to it. Always like the Dead Rising series in general. That's what I've always loved.
I've been told that we have received a broadcast from our field reporter Rebecca Chang, who is inside Fortune City.
It is clear that the outbreak started in the Fortune City arena during last night's Terror is Reality show. Information received from a behind-the-scenes source reveals that this outbreak was not an accident, but rather an act of terrorism. This shocking footage was obtained from a source inside the Fortune City Arena, the site of the Terror's reality game show. It may be upsetting to some viewers. Initial reports suggest that the man in the video is former motocross champion Chuck Green.
What? Shit. Just dropped my thing.
A member of the zombie rights protest group Cure was a contestant in tonight's pay-per-view game show. Acquaintances describe Green as a known drifter who is still angry over his wife's death in the Vegas outbreak. This horrible act of terror appears to be an escalation of violence for the protest group. This is Rebecca Chang, reporting live from the Fortune City Hotel in the heart of Fortune City.
What? That's complete bullshit! That was not me.
Did you have
And then this is pretty much where the game starts. It's like, no, hey man, you're the one that blew shit up.
My daughter and I barely get out of that arena alive. What possible reason would I have to do something like that?
Why are they saying you're part of Cure?
I went to one meeting, once. After I lost my wife.
I might look like a psychopath, but
I'm being set up.
I think I know why. It's not the first time members of Cure have been falsely accused of being involved with an outbreak. We were in town protesting that awful show you were on.
Do you believe me?
I don't know what to believe. But you sure don't seem like a terrorist. And I know we weren't involved.
Look, we have 3 days before the military rolls in. That's how much time I have to prove I'm innocent. The reporter, the one at the hotel. The tape she had, it's a complete fake. She said she had a source. Whoever that is must know more. I need to find out where she got it.
She said she was in the hotel. I'll keep an eye on your daughter. I won't say anything to her. I don't want her to worry.
There we go. All right, cool. But, yeah. Pretty much it's, like, the... Oh, wait. Like, I don't know if I can trust you. but keep bringing people back, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I got you. Yeah, maintenance key. Now I can build shit. I can build shit to my heart's content now. But the whole point of Dead Rising 2 was for him to, like, prove his innocence instead to show that he didn't blow it up. And that's something that I always thought was kind of cool about it. That he was just trying to do that, just to make sure that, like, nothing would happen. New message. Oh, man's trash. Okay. Yeah, see, I remember this was, like, the biggest thing. Was gonna be, like, hey, you can create your own weapons type thing. Or not your own, but, like, inspired weapons. There. Come on, let me get some of that. And when you look at, like, the movie titles and the other things, you're still able to get those, too.
Let's kick
some ass. Oh, look at all these. Arena entrance. Trigger happy lady. And also, these give you more, more points for doing. And the difference between this one and, the other Dead Rising off the record, was, if you do this, like, with this one, you can get all of them just through playing the game. But you can find ones that are around the map where it's like, hey, here is, like, this weapon, or this thing, or, like, you can do the special ability for that. That's what was cool about it, and, with Off the Record, they tried getting the, they tried getting another thing for it where it was like, you can just play through without the time limit or anything else being on, so you're not having to worry about that. I gotta go fucking grab that lady. Don't worry, LaFonda, I'm coming. I am running out of
patience. Anybody home?
Yeah, you all right, lady? Lady, it's Lester. I don't know what the hell. The Watkins. All right.
Hey.
I'm a little. Old twerp husband. The skinny guy that's real nervous. Alright, cool.
Now you got it.
Yeah, after I'm gonna go grab that thing, because then I can make another one of my favorite weapons.
You go!
That's pretty much, yeah, I'm gonna let those two hug it out. That's pretty much like, crazy, like, knuckle gloves. Yeah, there we go. They're the tenderizers. I love those things. Those are, like, my favorite weapons. Okay. Such a coward, I can't believe whatever. Yeah, okay.
Sure.
The big-boned woman over there. Alright, come on, people, let's go.
Cool. Still there?
This is terrifying!
And another weapon that I loved in this was that's probably the best thing. That isn't a boss weapon. Come on, ladies, let's go.
Stick close! Stick to me!
Help me!
Wait there!
Alright, come on.
Keep it moving! Stick with me! Follow me! Stick close! Faster.
But yeah, one of
Don't
the best weapons
behind.
That you can have on here is, I forget what the name of it is, but it's an axe and it's a sledgehammer together. and that was my favorite weapon. I remember me and my buddy Todd would always run around with those things. And whenever you get, like, max level, you just swing it around just constantly, like, in a circle. And it was always so awesome, because, like, it was one of the best weapons to kill bosses with. That and the lightsaber one, because the lightsaber one's really easy to make. It's, like, kill a looter that has a light. And then the other one was, like, just grab some gems that you can find in the beginning store. And a reason why that was so good is because it's so easy to make. Like, it's like, here, there's gonna be a shit ton of looters, so kill that guy, grab that, and just run through it with it. That, and for me, now, since since this has all the DLCs on it, the spiked baseball bat will be pretty good. Not for damage, but just for overall, like, oh, I can do shit with this. That's why it'd be pretty good. Excuse me. That's why it'd be good. And for me, I don't need this. I keep pressing the other button. There, take that. I don't need that. And also, too, this is when they added in, like, really cool, like, animations and kills. So I'm gonna make me up some tenderizers. The one thing I do need to figure out and to see if it actually works would be, if I can just grab it and then put, like, make it into a weapon. Because if I can do that, I'm gonna make myself, the knifed boxing gloves, because those are good too. Pretty much make, like, Wolverine claws. I'm just gonna skip that, because honestly, we've seen it. We've seen it before, so. And if you guys have already seen that, it's like, man, you know, we've already seen that before. Like, I love the badass music and everything, but yeah, it's just better to do this. Yeah, I actually don't want the sledgehammer. I can always grab another one. So there we go. Grab you. We'll grab you. And we're gonna see if this will work, because I think that's how this game worked. I think if you had the right combination, you could make it, but you won't be able to do the cool moves like that you can actually do when you get the card. And the downside with Off the Record was about that, was you can do the same thing. Yeah, okay, you can do that. Okay, cool. Yeah, so there. That's what I thought was super cool about this game. Even if you didn't have the right thing, you can still do it. But yeah, with Off the Record, it was pretty shitty with, One Man's Trash. And Platinum Strip. Platinum Strip. We'll just go to... We'll go over there. Oh yeah, I also forgot, you can give Katie, presents. That's another thing I forgot that you can do. And giving her presents is a really easy way to level up yourself, because you can start a new game, drop her a bunch of presents, and then just keep rinse, repeat. So that's always a good thing that you can do with that, but... message, short-sighted. It's like a confused lady in the children's castle. God, I miss having a broom. It's something I can tell you for a fact that I miss. I miss having room on here. I miss it so bad. Oh yeah, and then there's the Elvis clothes over here. I'm just gonna make a bunch of these cards right now, because why not? There we go. The Footin' Lizard.
Like Mom used to make.
Fuck's sake. There we go. The good thing is you can get some pretty decent PP just for like killing all these dudes with your like not leveled up thing. Yeah, that was always a really good thing about this Dead Rising game, and same with off the record. Like, I hate games where pretty much you're just like, okay, since you don't have this thing, you can't use it. That's the stupidest fucking thing. Like, I hate that so much with games. Like, some games, I hate it. It's so dumb. Like, that shouldn't even be a goddamn thing. Oh yeah, I forgot. Okay, I can't make that until I actually find, like, the thing where it's like, hey, look at this. But yeah, but yeah, no, it's just, it's disappointing because, I know there's a couple games out there that are honestly like that, and it's stupid. Like, it's really stupid. There, since I have the chance, I can just move that real quick. So yeah, let's see what weapons I got here. I gotta check that one place after. So there's like so much to do on here. Same with Off the Record. Like, Off the Record I'm gonna record too, but to me I'm debating on like starting it at like a better level. Okay, there we go. There's Chad. Don't worry, Chad. I'm gonna come save you. Wait up. Wait, bro. There we go. Gotta save your lady. She's over there. Okay, now you're, like, bringing people over here. Oh, he shot me, you asshole. You fucking asshole, he shot me. There we go, yeah, inventory increased, and now combo card, now I can make a Molotov.
Perfect.
Alright, come on, Chad, let's go.
Keep going!
I already know where she is, so that's the best part about it. But yeah, with this game, I like it way better than Off the Record, because with Off the Record, like, I liked that they added Uranus Zone. That's supposed to be, like, this alien area. That's actually supposed to be, like, somewhere over here. That's the thing that I liked about it. And it was just, it was something new, but it was like, it felt like a big DLC, but you get to play as like Frank West, and that was honestly the biggest highlight for me, was just being Frank again, because I love Frank. Like, not even saying that Chuck was bad, and even too, it's like Chuck got to make his own appearance in that, where he was a psychopath. And that's what I liked about it, where, like, instead of him, like, you know, being able to be like, oh, here, we just made it through this shit. He turned into a psycho because Katie died. Because he just couldn't stand it.
Shoot, partner.
Yeah, this is the era where, like, I'm not gonna lie, this is the era where Dead Rising got super easy. Oh, I love that my face is just caked in blood. That's awesome. Okay, we got a safe room, so. There we go. Let's go.
Peaches and cream!
Faster! Hurry up! Stick with me!
And also, this is where getting people along places became so much easier.
Ah! Faster! This way!
This is where this became so much easier. Platinum strip. Okay, remains trash. Like, this game was so easy to, like, bring people over and everything. Like, I remember I even got the Willamette Mall outfit. That was the one that I ran through the most, because that was, like, one of the hardest things to do, where it was, like, get everybody over here.
Keep moving!
Oh yeah, and also, they added shops in this thing, too. Oh yeah, that's all they were introducing to me. Shit, I'm so sorry. Oh, whoopsie. Okay, so yeah. If you haven't played this, yeah, you can buy Zombrex if you have enough money, and then you can buy all these other things, pretty much. But the thing is, you can always just level up and do it, or, you know, just figure it out. Two men are at Shanks. One is fighting, the other is crying. Okay. And the only downside why I don't like buying from that place, it becomes more costly every time because, you know, the looter is right, so, you know, they're wanting just all of this. So, that's the biggest reason why, let me just move that, because I forgot. I can see my kill counter right there. Sorry, I'm trying not to block anything. But, but yeah, it's not too great. Okay, and wait, no, Uranus Zone's over here. Sorry, I'm so wrong. Yes, Uranus Zone is right here. Can I get you guys in the back of this? No, I can only get one. Okay, we're getting it. Okay. Here, come on, people. Let's keep
Don't
going.
Fall behind. Move it.
Might just do live on location. Van's starting to run out of shit.
Stick with me. Let's go. Keep close.
Or yeah,
Still
no,
there?
Actually, we're good for
keep
live
going.
On location. But yeah, see, Don't this is what I mean. Behind. Like, honestly, the zombies are more docile in this game. That's always been kind of the best part about it. Like, they're not, like, completely docile, but, you know, they're good enough where you're not gonna have to worry about, like, AIs getting stuck. Even though it still can be fucking annoying, the AIs getting stuck. Oh, for good old time's sakes. Oh, baby. Okay, here we go. Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, there we go. Ride that. Ride it. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. Oh, I love that. There's me just riding on that thing. Alright. Wait, do you have a weapon? Okay, yeah, she does. Okay. I was like, man, what is she
Stick
doing?
To me.
Also, to oh, jeez, yeah. Also, another way to find some cool things are when you shoot, or like when you shoot and kill some guys. they'll actually drop, like, you know, their thing. Like, and when I mean their thing, I mean, like, what would it be? Their blueprint for their weapon, that's what they'll drop. Yeah, they'll drop their blueprint for their weapon.
Keep it moving!
That's what I always liked about it. Just trying to see if I found that other, if this blueprint's around here. I don't think so. Alright, whatever, that's fine. Let's go, people.
Follow me! Stick with me!
See, I'm not gonna lie, if this was Dead Rising 1, those people would have been fucking dead. Ooh, there we go. Beautiful.
Yes.
Alright, come on, lady.
Keep close!
Come on, people, let's just run.
Let's go!
And see, I love how they follow you. Like, that was the best thing about these, like, Dead Rising 2. When you're like, hey, follow me. It's like, they legit will follow you. Like, it wasn't, like, that bad of a problem. Like, compared to, like, the other Dead Rising game. Like, Dead Rising 1. Oh, I forgot. I gotta remember, too, they also have a little thing where it shows, like, a circle, where it shows a door, where that you can get them over.
Stick to me!
That's another thing I forgot, they added that, too, because a lot of people were, like, in the first one, they were like, that's annoying that you can't see what, if they're gonna be able to come to you. I'm just gonna run past these guys, just to make this easy for me.
Let's go! Hurry up! Keep it moving! This way! Still there? Come on! Hurry up! Keep going! Move it! Keep close! This way!
Yeah, I gotta get to a live on location. That's one mission I gotta get to go, or I have to go to soon.
Stick to me! Come on! Faster! Still there? Don't fall behind!
Well, they get that dang thing off your head. Oh, wait, no, sorry, no, it wasn't Proto Man. Sorry, no, in the other Dead Rising was Proto Man. No, it's actually Arthur's helmet. Okay, good, so I got these guys now.
Keep close! Hurry up! Faster! Keep going!
New skill required, so I have speed.
Let's go!
We're all coming? Okay, everybody's here?
Don't fall behind!
So I got jump kicks, so there. Now I can do what I did on my other Dead Rising thing, where it's just like run up, just boot them straight in the head. Oh shit, I didn't mean to come here.
Hey, buddy!
Oh shit. Yeah, I'm just gonna skip that because honestly, I don't feel like fighting this fucking animal. Okay, no, we gotta go.
Keep moving!
Yeah, we gotta go. I didn't even wanna fight, stick like, Snowflake.
Stick close! Don't fall behind! Faster!
Yeah, I know.
Let's go! Keep moving! Stick with me! Follow me! Still there?
Because this Snowflake way. Is a fucking annoying thing to get, faster. So honestly, like,
come on.
It's just, it's better to leave. Okay, stay you can close. Fuck off, Cap. Seriously.
Stick with me! Keep it moving! You, go there!
Fuck off, Ted, you fuck piece of shit. Oh, headbutt you. Oh, fuck you, fucking Ted, you fucking piece of shit. I'm gonna kill you because you're a psycho. Oh yeah, fuck you. So pretty much the main thing about that guy, sorry that I skipped it, is that he tries feeding people to the tiger. Even though the funny thing is that there's meat lying around there and you can toss it to him. I totally didn't mean to skip that, I'm so sorry. But he's like this, like, he's just this, like,
Snowflake.
Dude that kept trying to feed people
Kitty.
To the tiger.
Come, Kitty! You still hungry, girl? Take me, Snowflake! Ted feed you! Ted take care of you! Fresh meat! Just for you, Kitty! Kitty... Kitty... Time for... supper.
Such a gross boss. God, he's so gross. It's not as bad as the one on Dead Rising 3, where, like, she vomits all over everybody.
Don't fall behind!
Okay, yeah, no, don't follow me. Fuck, I didn't mean to do that.
Yeah.
I actually didn't mean to do that, guys. Go down there.
Stay over there!
There we go. I'll figure out something with Snowflake after. I probably won't even care about, like, getting that achievement, like, best father or whatever, because that, fuck, it's too annoying. It's, like, it's way, way, way too annoying. Yeah, we're just gonna fucking skip that, because honestly, we gotta go. Oh yeah, I forgot also, from when I wear the psycho outfit, the machete and the knife, you get different executions.
Come on! Keep it moving! This way! Keep moving! Still there? Follow me!
Yeah, sorry, it's been a while since I played Dead Rising 2, like...
Stick close!
With Dead Rising 1, it was something, like, it was different, because honestly, what I did with Dead Rising 1 was pretty much, hey, I'm gonna, like, play this. I'm gonna do that, like, I replayed it, actually, like, before it came out for backwards compatibility, so I played that a bit, I did it, and then it was like, you know, I wasn't so rusty.
Faster.
But for DR2, legit, after I beat Dead Rising 2, I never came back to it. It was just like, it wasn't bad, it was just like, I didn't want to play it again, because it felt like, I did everything on there, there was no reason to really come back. But now, where we stand right now, I can get everything back again. Most people just like this stuff, you know, to get achievements and everything else, and to me it's like, that's cool and all, but... But to me, I don't mind. Like, I just love playing through these old games again. And now I can actually do it with it not having to be on 360, so better graphics and everything else. There we go. There, now we're on live and location. We have the people that we wanted, and I'm gonna keep playing through here and we're gonna save it, because, man, goddamn. I'm still probably gonna keep playing for a bit longer, but shit, it's brutal. That was such a, like, a fuck-up on my end.
You need to pay attention out here, buddy.
Thanks.
Rebecca Chang, Channel 6 Action News.
Chuck Green.
Are you serious? From the security video. I thought you'd be long gone by now. Since you're sticking around, Care to answer a few questions?
I'm not your story, lady. I didn't have anything to do with the outbreak.
Right, sure you didn't. And that tape showing you tampering with the cages was...
a fake. I had nothing to do with this. My daughter and I barely got out of there alive. I need to know where you got that tape from and who your source is.
Reporters don't reveal their sources, Chuck. That's privileged information.
Privileged my ass. That wasn't me on the tape. I'm being set up.
Why should I believe you?
You don't have to. But you want the big story, right?
She is such a good character in this game. Like, I liked how she was, like, her whole thing in general.
It has to be an exclusive.
Sure. Doesn't matter to me.
I can't tell you my source, but there is a central security room.
If you haven't heard or seen what happened on this game, I suggest skipping to a later part after this cutscene. It sucks that she gets shot in the head. There you go. That's it. Because she was a really good character, and it's kind of like disappointing that she died. But they gave more of a reason for Stacy to be like the whole like Chuck and her together thing, you know, to ship that boat.
Come on.
But there now after I got that out of the thing. I know in Off the Record it's way different, like she's actually alive and she helps Frank because supposedly her and Frank know each other on that. And then that becomes Frank's love interest because another spoiler, if you haven't played it, and these games are old as shit, so if I get any comments about like, oh, you shouldn't be spoiling it. It's like, man, you know, I'm just gonna be like, it's a game that's been out forever, and honestly, you can go out and buy it, too. There's a bathroom, and for me, I need to use the bathroom. I gotta save. Haven't saved in a while. There we go. But yeah, Stacy dies on the other one because she's the main boss character. Yeah, that's the other reason, because she takes the role of another character on here.
Still there? This way.
Whatever you say.
And she kills the boss or the boss character from the other thing. So yeah. There's one thing I didn't spoil. I only spoiled one, and the one thing I spoiled was, oh, shit, I didn't hit him. Misclick. And I might honestly just drop this because I don't want to fucking... yeah, I don't want to, like, hurt any more people. Because that took out a mighty big chunk of that dude's thing.
Stick close! Let's go! Move it!
But yeah, yeah, she's good. Like, I like both the characters. I like Stacy and I liked her for this. It's kind of disappointing that they didn't, like, bring them back for the other game.
Head that way! Move that way!
For number three. But it was in a different city, so honestly, it's like, I can understand that being a reason why they didn't bring them back, but still, it was kind of a missed opportunity. But for Dead Rising 3, bringing back Chuck to be, like, you know, to be there was a good thing. I didn't mind it.
What, Sam Hill?
There we go. And also, too, for Dead Rising Off the Record, it doesn't really matter because it doesn't It doesn't, like, what do you call it? It doesn't matter too much because it's just, it's a reimagining of the game. Like, the Dead Rising 2 is what it was.
What are you waiting for?
Even though, to me, I still enjoy what's it called way more. Like, I like this one for the story and everything else and just introducing him as a new character. But I love Off the Record way more. Like, they bring back Adam the clown, like, one of his brothers. Who's like, hey, you know, you're Frank West, you killed my brother, type thing, and then he tries to kill you. Like, I love that. Like, I always loved that. Like, that was such an awesome, like, thing. And it could only work with him, because who the fuck would care about Chuck Green? Like, legit, the only character that would care about Chuck Green would be Jed. Like, if Jed had a brother, that would be the only character that would care about him. He would be like, oh, you're the guy that killed my brother. But Jed was a crazy motherfucker to begin with anyways. Like, I love it. Like, I think he tried, like, killing Chuck Green's daughter. Or something like that. Because in that Dead Rising game, pretty much what you do, you try to, like, just get out of the city. And it was just for you to get, like, level 15 before the game starts.
Don't bother. It's locked. You've got some interesting skills for a reporter.
No one ever got an award playing by the rules, Chuck.
Multiple people have gotten awards for doing that. And I just wanted to skip that, because honestly, it's nothing. Meet with the contestants. Oh, man. Okay, can we just weave through here? Good. Okay, that's what I wanted. I really don't feel like fighting Leon right now with all these people, because that's a heyday for him to just murder everyone. That's a heyday, I'm not gonna let happen.
You, go there!
That's a heyday I ain't gonna let happen. Also, I'm gonna give one of those other guys that shotgun I don't need anymore. I'll give you the shotgun. Here you go, fatty, let's go. I'll stick with broom handle. Come on, people, keep following me.
Faster! Still there? Keep moving! Stay close!
And honestly, too, this game's so easy enough to be able to just do it. You know what I mean? To be able to actually, like, just go through here and not have a problem. So it's like, I don't want to make myself have even more of a problem doing it. You know what I mean?
Stick with me!
Okay, come on, people.
Don't fall behind!
Oh, come on, Kenneth. You're kind of holding that fucking process here, fella. Perfect, 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 perfect. Oh, also too, Snowflake counts as a survivor, so that's the one person I'm not getting this time. Because Snowflake is a fucking piece of shit, and it's super hard to get. Oh, and also, the other cool thing about Dead Rising Off the Record is that the DLC outfits that are on here, you can get onto there, but they're in special locations. So, where you find the ninja like head, you have to go to the top of this thing and then you can put it on and wear it. But yeah, to me, I still think the Dead Rising Off the Record outfits looked way cooler than than this game's. Like, the two outfits that I thought that were the most worth to buy was the sports fan, because you can eat rancid food, you can eat anything and not feel sick. And the other one would probably be the ninja one, because I think the ninja you take less fall damage or some shit like that. I could be totally wrong, but I know the one that I always wore, and it was that horn hat right there. Don't worry, lady. He's coming. This old man's just taking his time. Taking his sweet old time. Yeah, well, I'll kill Leon after, so. And that was another dude who I liked on here as a villain that turned into Chuck Green on Off the Record. It was, it was Leon. Leon was a guy in Terror's Reality who you fight to get first place. So, that's what I thought was kind of cool about his whole gimmick and shtick. And, I loved fighting him, because he's such a fun character, because all his moves are really is just driving into you with a chainsaw bike. There we go. Perfect. That's like a DDT.
I should have known you two were in cahoots the first moment you set foot in this place. You caused nothing but trouble.
You're an innocent. It's a setup.
After you put this whole bunker at risk, you expect
me to believe that?
Hey.
Oh, well, looky here, man of the hour, Chuck Green. Should have listened to my gut and kicked you out when you got here.
Sullivan, I had nothing to do with this.
Also, too, Sullivan is one of the biggest snakes in the fucking grass, too, on this game.
Explain how that little trick works.
What's-her-face change roles.
Look, I don't care whether you believe me or not.
He's not like the final boss character, but he's one of the leading reasons why what happens here is his fault.
Just asking for a fair shot.
You could have told me that the front door was locked.
Hey, you're that TV lady. I'll make you a deal. You keep rounding folks up, you can keep coming and going. You die out there, and we'll have to leave it to the devil to sort you out. But ain't no one gonna cover your ass when the military arrives. You pull anything, anything, and I'll do whatever I have to do.
What was that all about?
He watches too much TV.
Tell me you found something.
We went to Central Security, but somebody got there before us. Everything was smashed. All the tapes were gone. Hey, no footage of my daughter.
Stacy, I'm Rebecca Chang, Channel 6 Action News. I'm here to help.
Oh, you'll forgive me if I don't think it's very helpful that you accused my organization of a crime we didn't commit.
Look, I don't know what's going on here, but clearly things are not as they seem. I put out the information I had at the time.
Remember, you can have all the exclusives you want if you help us figure out what's going on here.
Works for me, whether you're innocent or guilty. I just want the truth.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. But okay, we'll work together. I'll keep an eye on these monitors.
And I'm going back out there to see what I can find out.
I'll let you know if I see anything.
But yeah, for Dead Rising Off the Record, like, yeah, the difference is between that stuff is, oh yeah, and I can save again, cool. Pretty much some roles are reversed, but either way, like, it's the same as, like, Dead Rising 1, where the government's pretty much the main reason to blame, like how most of these games are. The government is, like, the entire reason to blame what's going on here, and also, I don't need to go there. There you go, just seeing if everything's still recording. And, I always, like, thought that was such a cool thing. Like, I loved all the boss fights for these games. Like, the only one that I can say that I actually was kind of disappointed about was this game. Dead Rising 2's boss fight was kind of flaccid. To me, it was kind of flaccid. Wasn't bad. It just was a little flaccid. Just a little bit. And a lot of people would probably say to me and be like, oh, why is it so flaccid? And the only reason to me why I feel it's so flaccid is because, honestly, Dead Rising, off the record, kind of outdid itself. Not saying that it's a better game. I'm just saying that it kind of outdid itself. Like, they tried pushing the boundaries of what the first boss was on here. Because the first boss on here... I'll just give you a setting so that I'm not spoiling anybody's thing. So you're fighting on the rafters, and you helped the final boss pretty much, like, get what he needed because he got bit. So, you give him that. You show mercy on him for giving you such this hard time. Like all this crazy shit, like, happening to you. Like, you pretty much give him mercy. And you're like, here, you know what? Like, even though you're a fucking piece of shit, I'm gonna heal it. Like, I'm gonna help you and make sure that you're taken care of. So you do that, and then you fight on the rafters, and he lays some traps and does some things like that. And it's cool, I guess, but, like, just how it ends is kinda lame. Because the final words that he says is, like, are you gonna win, or, like, we win big. And then, boom, you throw him down, and, yeah, that's pretty much it. And then you get a slight jump scare, because, you know, why not? And that's pretty much how that game ended. For me, I liked Off the Record so much more, like... It felt like they tried more with Off the Record. And another reason too, it's like, it's not even that, like, to me, I feel Off the Record was a better game. It was just that it had more, you know what I mean? But there still are problems. Like, for me, how I feel Off the Record, like, sandbox game mode should have been was, alright, here, boom, so this is how it's gonna go. Like, in my eyes, how I felt. What you should be able to have them to do is, like, you can still, like, pick up and do missions and do things, and, like, still make it feel like it's the original game, but without, the cases and all that. And even, like, the fun game modes with, like, oh, you know, invite your buddy and you guys can do this challenge together. Like, I thought that was super cool, but... I didn't like that a lot of those equal to you getting cards. And when I mean cards, it's like you're scratch and win cards.
Yes.
That's what I mean. So if you guys don't understand what I mean by cards. Like, that's what I thought was, like, that should have been, like, all in the campaign. Like, you should have been able to level up and to get that stuff. Instead of being forced to, forced to have to play sandbox mode to get, like, the rest of your cards. Because honestly, you want to at least try to get every scratch and win card on here, because it means you'll get the level up quicker, that and also for achievements and whatever. That plus two just to be a completionist, because that back then, I was a hardcore completionist. I always tried to complete everything to what I can do. And I still try to do that. And also here, I should check and see what we get up here, since I have a chance. And this is the location where, in Off the Record, you can get the headpiece for the ninja suit. So what do we get here? We get Dick. Except for a sniper rifle. Sniper rifle's actually pretty good. I'm gonna hush my mouth because, yeah, actually the sniper rifle's pretty fucking good. And then there's meat and whatever. For Off the Record, you get, like, a katana and, like, all this other cool stuff. Okay, yeah, so I don't take fall damage. That's what it does. Cool. Okay. Because I should have lost health from that. So yeah, that's kind of game-breaking. A little game-breaking. Alright, hello, lady. Hey, lady, don't be scared. I can help. we'll find a way to clerk. Tell you, yeah, man, Drew. Hooligans. Okay. I'm sorry, I'm shopping for my grandbaby. Okay. It's been an accident, whatever, an accident. Real zombies, whatnot. Okay, I'm just trying to save you, lady. I love that. I'm sorry. Can we please get out of here? I have to hurry. There you go. I'm carrying you. Sick. What do I want to draw? Fucking. All right, lady. Come on, let's go.
I want to go home!
Look, wasn't there firefighters' clothing in this game? No, it was for Off the Record. Sorry, I'm getting these games so mixed up. Yeah, for Off the Record, when you carry somebody or pick them up, Frank just jets. That's what I love about it. Like, for me, like, I rub, like, the charcoal all over my face so I can still have the other cool-looking outfits. And I loved that. That or even, like, the mustache. Like, the mustache was awesome. Like, you get, like, one of those, like, those old-style, like, big, like, mustaches. And when you carry people, you just jet. Like, you run. Like, it's so easy to carry people on there, and it's great. But to me, I think my favorite outfit for Off the Record was Cyber Frank. Check the role model. Okay, so yeah, there we go. Now I need there's two psychopaths up there. I'm gonna bring this lady back. I'm gonna kill fucking Brandon because Brandon's a piece of shit. And then I'm going to fight what's his face. There you go. Thank you, young man, for your kindness.
We were too kind.
Young man. But yeah, I kind of hope with Dead Rising 4 that the whole, like, I wouldn't mind to see them bring back, like, wearing clothing matters, because that would be really cool to see. But if they don't, they don't. Like, it ain't even, like, that bad. Barn burner. Vandalizing some slot machines. I think that one's for me giving people a fuck ton of money, and I don't have money to give to people. That's the best part about it. Like, I love that thing, where it's just like, oh, hey, like, we need this money. And it's like, hey, there's zombies out here. And it's like, no, man, we need this moolah right now. And that was another thing that I kind of miss about the old Dead Rising. Some people are like, hey, I want your money to do this. Compared to how the old ones are, it was like, hey, I'm just gonna save you, or here, I'm gonna give you food, or gonna give you whatever. Like, it's fucking annoying. It's like a Tamagotchi. Fucking annoying, man. Can I not jump over that? Fuck, you know, I'm gonna deal with Brandon first, because I haven't even done a fucking boss fight, so. Yeah, I feel bad. Sorry, people, I haven't even done a boss fight. You guys have been just watching me, like, just walk around here and not really fight anybody. There we go. Excellent.
Excellent.
Totally radical, bruh.
Growing. Soon
We'll all to me, this is one of my favorite chain. Boss characters, because I like his whole thing, that he's like crazy protester. Hey, that like lost his mind pretty much. And like that. Oh, Jesus Christ.
You'll be mine soon!
Oh my god, fuck, I forgot how long you are. Give me a minute. God, I hate that jump move he's got.
We'll all be free.
I always hated that jump move he's got. We're gonna just suck that down real quick. Gonna give you a nasty fucking paper cut. Ow, paper cut. Fuck, shit, fuck. You can get off me, man.
I'll make you a zombie soon.
I think I don't see you in there. Fuck's sakes, Ricky, fuck. Gotta hate that move, I hate it so much. I'm gonna betray shit, motherfucker. There we go. Let me just eat real quick. There we go. Snack. You expect a 50 cal bullet to just fucking blow this dude's head off. There we go. Fuck you. Such a lame fight. I love it. Aw, man. It's just like, just stab, stab, stab. Like, see, I wish I had that other weapon, but I forget how to grab the axe and everything to be able to fuck this dude up with. And I find it really cool how he dies. Like, I love how he gets bit, and he's like, oh, fuck me. It's like, nope, well, that's bad. There we go, now I got the gem blower. Sweet. Wait, let me just save real quick. Perfect. Can I pick you up and carry you? Or does it not work that way? Alright, come here, lady.
Stick close!
Stick to me!
Sure. Yeah, can I pick her up? Because that'd make this so much easier. No, I cannot.
This way!
Take the shitty cure poster. I don't need this shit anymore. Yeah, there, I've done a boss now, and I'll probably do another one after, but I want to barn burn with the contestants. Okay. Workers' composition. Oh, you fucking... Fuck you. Fucking love that guy. Oh, come on! Quit fucking hitting me, asshole! Fuck!
Keep going! Stick to me!
Are you gonna fucking hit me again? Or are we gonna have a fucking problem here?
Come on!
Alright, let's go.
Stick to me!
Okay, there we go.
Don't fucking fall behind! Assholes.
Like, I love it, he just, like, ran up and smacked the fucking shit out of me. It's like, dude, come on.
This way.
I'm here to help you, man. I'm here to help you. Yeah, I know in this, like, there's some really fucking annoying guys that are like, hey, man, like, I need this from you, and it's like, $1,000, and it's like, what are you gonna do with that? What are you gonna do?
Come on!
Kirsten. Ah, there we go, cool. Hey, lady.
Stick close!
Oh, gross.
Was that me?
There we go. Give her a hand.
Woohoo! Ouch!
Move it! Hurry up!
No!
Stick to me! Keep it moving! Faster!
Yeah, I thought the funniest part about this game that it was just strip poker. Like, that's how you get
Keep
a lot
going.
Of the cool outfits
Let's
and
go.
Everything.
Follow me!
It's just, hey, do strip poker and get their clothes. I forget how you get the armor for them, but I don't know. It's pretty cool. Like, I love getting
Stick
all
to
of
me.
What's the space's
Keep
armor.
Moving. Faster.
There we go. All right, come on, people, let's go.
Still there? Hurry up.
Yeah, after I put these people in, I'll probably end it and probably add on another part to this.
Stay close.
Because I would like to add a lot more into this episode.
Stick with me. Keep close. Keep going.
That looks like a good time to end it, too.
Keep it moving. Stick close. Let's go. Keep moving. This way. Stick close.
There you go. Perfect. Does this place use green technology? Are you fucking kidding me? Love that. Fucking hippies. Yeah, alright. I hope you guys enjoyed. Subscribe to my friend today, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Stay awesome, guys.